so many reasons. One reason is we are here with so many incredible parents. I want to let you know that your kids raised over $200 for the New Horizons School in Paraguay. Laura Clausen led the way in collecting old shoes for changing footprints. And as Jerry mentioned, we had two big boxes, very similar to these black ones over here, filled with old shoes, worn shoes. And we will open up that opportunity for you all to join in on that for a few more weeks here. So if you have an old pair of shoes, it doesn't matter if it's one shoe, two shoes, three shoes, bring them in. They can have holes, they can stink, or they can be all nice and pretty. Just set them right out here by the rack where we normally set the food. We'll keep it away from the food, of course. So another thing I want everybody to know this year is that we use the Orange VBS program. And this program is similar in scope and style to our weekly Orange Express children's programming. So, in fact, June and July's theme is Raise Your Game and Power Up. So that's what we were speaking about all summer long. It's on a smaller scope generally throughout the year, and the summer is even a little bit different yet. So when we kick back into school, our regular programming will kick in full force at that point. I'm going to catch everyone up really fast on what we've been doing this week at Power Up. So kids, just know your families may have a few questions, and you kids may need to explain some things to them. And so that's really perfect, because one of the things that we do at Orange is red is for the heart of the family, and yellow is for the light that the church helps to shine into our lives. And as we learned in art class, red and yellow make orange. And so that's where our curriculum is. We help to shine the light of Christ into your family life, and therefore we also provide some things for you to take home and to talk with your kids throughout the week. Now, before I tell you what we've been talking about this week, I need to find out something. How many of you parents played video games? Maybe you still play video games. Anybody? Me too. So some of the games you might remember playing, there is a theme to one earlier today, just as I was walking up here, which was my favorite, Pac-Man. Down here, we have Mario over here, Donkey Kong, Space Invaders. Well, this week, as we gathered, we began playing a real-life video game. So, we link this into power-ups because we all know that if we, in Mario, if we eat a mushroom, we get bigger. And if you catch a bouncing star, you get to be invisible. But this week we're talking about real life power-ups, which are the real ways that God gives us to raise our game. We've talked about how God wants us to know him and how we can know God through his word, and even how God sent his son Jesus to save us. We have one verse that we want to remember even after our time at Power Up is over. Kids and parents, let's all say this verse together. God's power has given us everything we need to lead a godly life. Okay, now power it up just a little louder. God's power has given us everything we need to lead a godly life. God has given us ways to live bigger and more powerful lives. That is what this week that is what we mean when we say power up. For the week, we divided up into teams by grade. So we had kindergarten, first, second, third, and then our preteen group, which is fourth and fifth graders. We played some crazy games, as I mentioned earlier, and assigned points. And while the elementary started their day in here, our preschoolers started their day over in the by rooms near the orange sign-in area where they had social activities together. Our days began right here in Celebration Hall, where we began the day with the real-life video games. Bryce Miller, one of our youth leaders, was our MC for those games. We all love race games like Mario Kart, but this week we let some of our group leaders be the participants. And so we had a tricycle race right here in Celebration Hall. The kids loved rooting on their leaders. That same day we learned from another one of our youth leaders, our storyteller, Laura Clausen, about God's promise to Abram. Our bottom line was God wants you to know him. And we explored in our small group sessions the key question, how do you get to know God? Our preschool kiddos had a similar lesson, but with adaptations that were more appropriate to their ages. Every day the kids made cool crafts, played fun games, had a snack, sang with the Chumbandas, and sang and danced with Amanda Lindorf. Our preschool friends' days were just a little bit different. They also sang with Amanda and had snacks, but they got to watch a short video for their Bible story during their small group sessions. And their game time was enjoyed on the playground when it wasn't raining, and in their rooms they got to play when it was raining. Tuesday, we came together and played Space Invaders. What? How do you play Space Invaders? It was fun, it was interesting, but we all played Space Invaders. And we watched as our boy king knocked down altars, just like the Bible story. That was Josiah, the boy king. Our bottom line was, you can know God through his word. And in small group with Janelle Hadley, they discussed the key question, why is it important to discover what God says? Wednesday was a real-life version of Crossy Road, right here in the center section. Crossy Road is a new version of Frogger. Do you guys remember Frogger? The frog had to survive the street. Well, Crossy Road is the chicken had to cross the road, and this really is a video game. So we had real-life Crossy Road right here. Wednesday is the big day when we learned about Jesus. Our story encompassed Jesus' birth and his baptism. We learned our bottom line was God sent Jesus to save us, and our key question, why do we need to be rescued? Thursday, we played Stomp the Mushroom. What? So it was a mushroom on a cup, coffee cup, and the kids got to stomp these as one of their leaders put it out in front of them. So if you've ever played Super Mario Brothers or another Mario game, you might have seen Mario stomp on the mushroom. Thursday, that same day, we talked about Pentecost and how the Holy Spirit came to be with us. Our bottom line was God sent his spirit to help you. And our key question was, how can God's spirit help you? Friday's bottom line told us, you can help others know God. And we discussed how we can help others know God. Well, we can help others by making a fruit salad. What? Yes. A fruit salad, you ask? Yes. What better way to reveal the fruit of the Spirit than by making a fruit salad? So I think we've all made some great progress here today, talking about how God's power gives us everything we need. So let's go over our memory verse again together. if you'll say it with me. God's power has given us everything we need to lead a godly life. That's a huge idea. Everything. Think about everything in your whole life. God gives it to you so you can live in a way that is powerful and meaningful. Now, I think it's time that we go through a few specific power-ups that God has promised for everyone who follows him. I'm just going to list these off, and everybody, listen for a way that you think they might sound if they were power-ups inside a video game. So are you ready? This is the interactive portion. Let's say together some of the power-ups that God's Spirit gives us. Everybody say love.
Power of love.
Oh, good one. Now everybody say joy.
Joy. Power of joy.
Makes me have joy just hearing you guys. All right, now everyone say peace.
Power of peace.
Peace. Now say patience.
Power of patience.
Kindness.
Power of kindness.
Goodness.
Power of goodness.
Faithfulness.
Power of faithfulness.
Okay, now just parents say gentleness.
Power of gentleness.
Oh, we might have to give the parents their own team so we can give them some points this week. But I'm betting the kids can be even louder. So kids, I want to hear you say self-control.
Self-control. Power of self-control.
Now those are just some of the power-ups that God has promised us in Galatians chapter 5. The fruit of the Holy Spirit produces is love, joy, and peace. It is being patient and kind and good. It is being faithful and gentle and having control of oneself. Parents, you can ask your kids about the fruit salad we made. We can carry those with us at home, to school, to work, everywhere we need a power-up. Let's take a look at a short video montage of the kids and adults who made VBS an event this year, and then we will all celebrate together by filling this place with some